Hey Artnerds! So in an earlier tutorial, I showed you guys kind of the basics of doing perspective roughs. Today we're going to be talking about double page spreads. And I've already started this double page spread for the bonus chapter. And in an earlier tutorial, I think you guys saw me attach these two halves of the double page spread together. So today, all I'm really focusing on is finishing this other half of the spread. And I'm gonna demonstrate it, but it's actually a very simple technique. It's just handy to know in case you wanna kind of replicate what I'm doing for your own comic. So working on a double page spread isn't much different than using a single page, especially if you have panels that might need, you know, like layout grids, etc. So really, my main concern is I work on it one page at a time, and I block off areas that I want to protect using paper and blue tape. So, you know, pretty similar to what I talked about in the other comic tutorials. So I will show you guys by doing this panel here. Now, one of the things I would normally do is I would tape down at the bottom, but since that's not really an option, I'm just gonna tape it down over here to the side. So once it's taped off, you can just begin drawing as normal. Thank you. So I think you guys can see that that's not really too much different from just working on comic pages in general. You just kind of have to adjust where you tape. Now, where these two have been connected, the center seam, it may catch on your pencil a bit. So that's just another consideration to keep in mind. You can also separate them if that's easier for you. For this spread, I could have very easily separated them, but sometimes you have a double page spread where the image is just one image. And in that case, you would just be taping off the whole image. Really, how you handle your spread is gonna depend on the spread itself. So I'm gonna work on the remaining three panels in time lapse. right, so that about wraps up this segment of comic prep and process working on a double page spread. Hopefully you guys saw that this can be pretty easy. If you're working digitally, there's no reason to split up your pages. You can just work on them as a whole and then split them after you're finished drawing them. This spread was particularly easy because even though it is a spread and I designed it to work together, it's just two pages of individual panels. The reason I'm treating it as a spread here is I want to make sure they're run together when I print volume 2, and I want to make sure that I design them so that it doesn't read like this way, but hopefully it will read this way and this way. There's still some things I want to do with this digitally, from adding possibly Naomi's head in some of the corners to serve as narration, to possibly adding time codes to give a feel for the pacing of the day, to correcting some of these panels, maybe pulling some of these panels out or restaging some of these panels. But I'm going to do that digitally because, as I mentioned in some of my earlier videos, it is easier for me to redraw than it is for me to draw. So having this here as a framework is going to be so much easier for me to correct digitally later on. So when I'm going to scan this, I am going to separate these two pages and then scan them individually. So I hope you guys found this tutorial helpful, useful, and informative. I hope you guys are working on your own comic projects. And if you're interested in learning more about making comics, I have loads of tutorials here on this channel, from drawing to writing to planning for comics, as well as even laying out and printing your own comics at home. So if you want to make your own comics and zines, this channel is a great resource for you. I hope you guys enjoyed it. If you did, make sure you click subscribe if you're not a subscriber yet, and hit the bell notification so you never miss an update. On Fridays, I do an art stream, so if you have any questions, please join me on Fridays at 8 p.m. CST for my Power Hour art stream. I do demonstrations and answer questions, so that could be a great opportunity to get some feedback or to get a demonstration to help you better understand a concept that you might be having some trouble with. And if you like my art and you like what I do, please read my comic 7-inch Kara at 7inchkara.com and 7inchkara.tumblr.com. Those are the two for web access points. That sounded weird. Those are the two places you can read it as a web comic. Aha, that's better. If you're more of a print comic kind of person, you can buy a copy of volume 1 in the Natto shop, or you can fill out a library request form with your local library and they will get the book for you, and that costs you nothing but your time, and it helps me out a lot. I hope you guys will keep an eye out for the volume 2 Kickstarter. As you guys can see, I am working towards that, slowly putting in the time. As you guys know, making comics can be a really time-consuming process. So hopefully you guys will join me for the Kickstarter as well. So, keep an eye out for more comic prep and process videos, and check out nattosoup.blogspot.com for some of the in-between stages that I don't cover in video format. Thank you guys so much for watching. I'll see you guys again really soon. Bye guys!